Recreational fishing is big business in the coastal Everglades. This area is famous for hard-hitting sport fish like largemouth bass and snook.
All right, we're gonna head off to the rookery.
Dave Rose and his buddies have been making the trip from the Florida Keys to Flamingo practically every full moon for the past few decades. It's a long trek down the Shark River, deep into the interior of the Glades. But when you see the sun rise over Coot Bay, you understand why this trip is a monthly tradition.
I've got these guys catching a bass every month now, and Larry's done it about 7 years, so that's 84 months without missing a bass, and Mike's done it over 8 years, and I've done it almost 34 years. I've caught a bass every month for 34 years. Pretty nice fish right there.
Dr. Jennifer Rehage and her graduate students, Ross and Jessica, fish without lures or live bait. They use electricity. Shocking, isn't it? They're studying fish populations in and around the Shark River using a special electrofishing boat provided by the U.S. Geological Survey.
The focus of our work in the Everglades is really to understand fish. So we're very curious about a number of things about fish. In this area, we like to know more about how fish respond to the seasonality and the hydrology. So water levels go up and down, they get saltier and fresher, and we want to understand how fish respond to this variation that happens on a yearly basis.
The Everglades is an incredibly dynamic system, and it has changed a lot, partly due to human activity. In order to get a broad picture of the fishery and how it has responded to changes in the environment over time, lots and lots of data needs to be collected. But where do we start?
So our work in this part of the Everglades focuses on snook and bass. And there are really two important reasons why we focus on those. First, they're what we called mesoconsumers in the habitat, meaning they're at the middle of the food web. They're not at the top, they're not at the bottom, so they're really good indicators of what happens in the ecosystem. So that's one really good reason. The other reason is that both species are really important recreational fisheries. So we have a lot of recreational angling that happens in the Everglades, and both of these species are targeted by anglers. So they really allow us to link what happens with freshwater and the way we manage water, the way we restore the ecosystem to fishes, to what people care about, which is in this case is the fisheries. So that's a really nice link that we can provide by studying these two species in particular.
With enough data, Dr. Rehage and her crew can obtain a clearer understanding of changes and trends in fish populations across seasons and years. Collecting that data is the challenging part, but electricity makes things a bit easier and a lot more fun.
Electrofishing is a non-lethal sampling technique used to capture fishes. Unlike regular fishing, it doesn't require fishes to be hungry. Electrofishing works by pumping electricity into the water through a series of cables and wires that creates an electro field around the boat. Once fishes enter this electric field, they become temporarily immobilized, allowing researchers to net them, put them in the holding tank, and conduct research on these fishes. After our research is conducted, we can release these fish safely into the water with no harm done.
For scientists like Jennifer, Ross, and Jessica, gathering large amounts of data is crucial to their research. But this is a huge job for just a few scientists. That's when they had a brilliant idea. Why not partner up with folks that love the Everglades just as much as they do?
CAST stands for Coastal Angler Science Team, and we're working directly with recreational anglers to help research fisheries in the Everglades. So the idea for CAST started out in the field while we were doing research. We spent a lot of days on the water, and while we were there, we started becoming friends with some of the anglers that spend a lot of time out there. And we realized it's a great opportunity to get them involved in what we're doing because they're invested in the resource and they're already out there fishing and putting the time in. So that's how it first started.
Now, whenever Dave and the southernmost bass anglers fish the Everglades, they make sure and scan each bass and snook they land.
That's a recapture.
Once in a while, they catch a fish that has been implanted with one of Dr. Rehage's pit tags. They call this a recapture. And when they get one, everyone's excited.
Yes, yes. Yes! We got one, sir. We have a scanned recapture. Giant.
So recapture data actually provides us a lot of information on fisheries populations in the Everglades. So every time we put a tag out, we know how big a fish was, where it was, and when we put it out. So when they get recapture data, we can see how much the fish grew, where it moved, and then we can also use the ratios and estimates of how many fish tagged versus recaptured to get an actual population size of the fish. So we can estimate the health of the fishery, the abundance, and also how well fish are transitioning from juveniles to adults and so forth.
Yep, good shape too, good shape. Thumbs up! Marker.
Dave and his buddies also use a homemade set of beaded strings to keep track of what they land. In fact, he has over 30 years of meticulous records, which he has been happy to share with Dr. Rehage's team. This has proven to be a treasure trove of valuable data.
About 220 fish, one single day.
Dave Rose is the classic example of a citizen scientist and has made a huge contribution just by doing what he loves, catching fish.
That's a nice bass right there.
Dr. Rehage and her team benefit from tons of extra data that they couldn't collect on their own. Their research, in turn, will benefit the anglers.
Being able to create cast has been a great experience because although we're out there doing research and trying to understand the fishery, we're doing it essentially for people like Dave Rose and our cast members who have enjoyed the Everglades and the fishery for their entire life. So the information that we're finding out will be able to actually influence their fishing experience and hopefully preserve it for the future.
With a better understanding of what affects fish populations and why, we can better understand how to keep the fisheries healthy. It's a win for the ecosystem and for recreational fishing.
Over the past 10 years of our research, we learned a ton of information about fish in the mangroves in the Everglades. There are a lot of things we didn't know before that now we know. One of the main key findings of our work is the notion or the idea that freshwater flow, not totally surprising, drives a lot what happens in the estuary. So how we manage water upstream, outside the estuary, affects what happens in the coastal mangrove region. It affects the fish movement, it affects the diets of fish, it affects their abundance, their survival. And these are all the things that matter for creating a healthy population of fish for a recreational fishery, for instance. The links between the estuarine fishes, their health, their abundance, their diets, their reproduction, to what happens upstream with freshwater is really, really strong, and that's something we didn't know before our research.
When you care about something, you learn as much as you can about it so you can care for it the right way. That's what Dr. Rehage, Ross, and Jessica are doing. And that's what Dave Rose and the Southernmost Anglers are doing.
If you're interested in participating in any of these citizen science programs that occur in Dade County and in South Florida, please look up your local county websites, as well as visit the Everglades National Park websites. If you'd like to participate in our Angler Citizen Science program, please contact us on the web via www.cast.fiu.edu.
That is one serious blue crab.
All right, we're gonna put this guy in time. Time out. Let's process him.
Whoa. Detect camera.
That's awesome.
What is it?
It's a fish. Oh, you're such a good guy.
What is it? Oh, it's an American eagle, I think.
Really? It is. Oh my God, look at the head, how awesome it looks. That is so awesome.
What?
Look at its mouth.
That is an amazing, look at the bones.
Hold it up to pretend to eat it.
Wow, God. The jaw structure is
like
great.
As long as him.
So the stomach was loose.
Right? That smells awful.